Our next guests, I'm going to give them a second to get in here as I slide over. Talking with Rusty Jones and Tom Buschke, the co-founders of Hello Water. What's up, guys?
Hey, what's up?
I know you guys work for Hello Water because you got the matching gear. It looks great.
Thank you.
So tell us a little bit about your product. I mean, again, water doesn't really do justice to what you guys are doing. This is a different kind of product, has some added functionality. I'll let you guys describe what exactly you're doing.
Yeah, I've got a nutrition background. I've been a nutritionist for about 15 years. And so I'm constantly kind of trying to come up with innovative products that truly can solve people's problems, that can truly help people. Water being the category that it is, we knew that taking a functionality like fiber, which everybody needs and is not getting enough of, and making it taste great, kind of giving this modern delivery system without any sugar, you know, it's on trend without any of the sugar, all natural ingredients. We knew if we could make it taste good, that people would be attracted to it, and we found out that they certainly are.
You know, I encourage, viewers at home to sort of check out a bottle if you haven't, because you guys did a really interesting job with the branding, really cool marketing design, sort of and even the concept, Hello Water. What was sort of the idea behind that?
Yeah, that's really where it's at. So Hello is this conversation, right? So we knew that we couldn't be a Me Too brand, and we had to, break through the mold. So we took this not-so-sexy function in fiber, it's not hip as kombucha, cool as antioxidants, and we took our branding and really just wanted to inspire people. So we took this emotional branding, really gave it some character, a smile, laugh, love, live and dance, as opposed to just naming out the flavors, and it's really shareable. So you have millennials who, they really want their product to be, just a compliment to their lifestyle, whether it fits in their purse or it's on the go. And they can share this, whether it's social media and, we really just want to have somebody, share a smile, share a laugh, share a love. And along the way, we sneak a little fiber in and it helps their daily diet. And that's kind of where it's at.
Yeah, it's a cool way to engage with customers for sure. And I know we talked, I think, for a story a couple months ago or not too long ago. And we talked about how 2017 was kind of a concept year for you guys ahead of a big push into 2018 next year. What were some of the biggest lessons that you learned just in building out the concept and just having that experience this past year?
I mean, to me, I think it's really putting together the right team. So once we thought we've got the concept, we've really got something here, it was, okay, how can we attract really good people to be part of this team earlier than we thought? We thought maybe we'd start building a team in 2018, but that team is starting to come together now.
Yeah, and it's, along with that, it's just doing the small stuff. We're waiting for these home runs to happen, whether it's landing, great retailers or, being in Uber and LinkedIn and things like that. But it's doing the small stuff. It's finding your story, finding your mission, being, in this, together. And again, just the small stuff, the 2 a.m., BevNet videos and figuring out what it is that you need to do to get to, that retailer and really, make your brand spark. So
it's a hustle right now, that's for sure.
Absolutely.
It's a nonstop hustle. 24, if you want to get in the business and you're just getting started, it's a 24/7 grind.
Well, is there any, you guys have had a long history in the beverage business, a lot of different ventures. Any advice to some, young entrepreneurs? There's a lot of people around here who are sort of getting in entry-level startup style. So is there any, based on your experience, any advice you'd like to share?
Yep.
I think your speakers this morning kind of nailed it. It's be innovative, come up with something different, do not do a Me Too, start a new category, disrupt a new category, whatever you have to do something innovative. Once you commit to it, absolutely stay laser-light focused and just go and just grind. Good things will happen.
And it goes back to team, too. Tom and I are on the phone and texting every day, and we've got great investors, and we've got, a great marketing manager and a great community manager that help us while we're out building it. They're, still building the brand while we're, hanging out at BevNet Live. So you got to have a good team that, you want to work with. So,
absolutely. And then we got probably around 30 seconds left. You want to give listeners a quick idea of where they may be able to find Hello Water next in this coming year, in the coming months, retail distribution wise?
Yeah, absolutely. So we're born in Chicago, so we're making the Midwest our home. We're in about 600 retailers now. We'll be in about 1,000, hopefully by the end of the year, beginning of Q1. So really, Chicago, Milwaukee is our hometown. We've got great independent retailers and Syndix and Woodman's and a lot of those things. You can check us out at hellowater.com. We're on Amazon. And yeah, so you'll see us in more bigger places soon.
And no more Chicago soda tax. That's
done with.
Happy about that.
So thank you. Thank you for politicians who made that happen, or the people that really reversed that. So
Great. Well, thank you guys so much for your time.
Thanks, Marty.
Really appreciate it. Enjoy
Thanks,
the rest of the show, and I hope to talk to you guys again soon. All right, that's all from the live stream lounge for now. We want to thank our sponsors, AFS, Sovereign Flavors, and Ingredion, of course. We will be back at 12:35 p.m. Pacific time with Ryan Ziegelman, president of Evolution Fresh. I will be back, so I hope to see you then. We'll be right back.